support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK, B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. Swift BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace Team, the solution for humanity.
Solution for humanity.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الملك الحق المبين، وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. We'll come back once again and we continue inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala after having concluded the first of the six pillars of Iman, belief in Allah. We move on now inshallah azza wa jal to the second of them, the belief in the angels, al-malaika. Malaika is the Arabic word for angels. It is the plural and the singular form is malak. Malak is an angel. It comes from the word aluka, and aluka refers to a private message or a private messenger that's sent with a private message. And the reason being is that this is what the angels are originally known for. They were dispatched by Allah, the Mighty and Majestic, to carry messages to His prophets. And these messages initially are privately intended for that prophet. In the very first verse of Surah Fatir, Allah the Most High, He says, Alhamdulillahi fatiri samawati wal ard, ja'ili al malaikati rusula, uli ajnihati mathna wa thulatha wa ruba'. All praise belongs to Allah, the originator of the heavens and the earth, the one who made out of the angels messengers. There's the connection. Messengers with wings, two or three or four, and He increases in His creation whatever He wishes. So since the angels, though, are a matter of the unseen world, we can only find out about them through revelation, through the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So our task, bi-idhnillah, in this episode, is to learn a bit about the world of the angels from the Qur'an and Sunnah, and then talk about what we can benefit from the creation of the angels and our belief in these angels. So first of all, Allah the Most High informed us on the tongue of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that they were created from light. That doesn't necessitate, by the way, that they are currently light now, in the same manner that we were created from clay, from mud, as human beings. But we're not currently mud now. We're not going to dissolve and wither away if we're placed in water. So in Sahih Muslim, the hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she narrated the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, خُلِقَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ مِن نُورِ. The angels were created from light. وَخُلِقَ الْجَانُ مِنْ مَارِجٍ مِنْ نَارٍ. And the jinn, the jinn, were created from the flame of a fire. وَخُلِقَ آدَمْ مِمَّا وُصِفَ لَكُمْ. And Adam, alayhi salam, the first man, was created from that which was described to you, meaning in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From dust, and then from mud, and it was clay, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala breathed a soul into it. Also, what we know about the angels is that they are great in multitude. We have, for example, the hadith of Malik ibn Sa'sa'ah radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Bukhari and Muslim, wherein the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that during his magnificent night journey and his ascension to the heavens, al-Mi'raj, he says, فَرُفِعَ لِيَ الْبَيْتُ الْمَعْمُورُ And then erected in front of me was الْبَيْتُ الْمَعْمُورُ which is the Kaaba of the heavens, the Kaaba of the angels. He says, فَسَأَلْتُ جِبْرِيلُ So I asked Jibreel عليه السلام about this house. He said, this is الْبَيْتُ الْمَعْمُورُ يُصَلِّي فِيهِ كُلَّ يَوْمٍ 70,000 ملك Every single day, 70,000 angels pray in it. إِذَا خَرَجُوا مِنْهُ لَا يَعُودُونَ إِلَيْهِ آخِرَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ Once they exit it after praying therein, they never return to it for as long as they exist. Meaning, every brand new day, 70,000 new angels pray in Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur. How far back has that been happening? Until when will that continue to take place? The numbers of the angels. This is similar to the other hadith wherein he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَطَّتِ السَّمَاءِ وَحُقَّ لَهَا أَن تَئِطْ That the skies, the heavens above us, they have creaked or groaned. You know, wood, when something heavy walks upon it or is placed on top of it, it creaks. He says the skies have creaked like this and they have every right to creak. And then he explained why, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by saying that there is no space therein. Four fingers wide, except that there's an angel there, either bowing or prostrating to Allah the Mighty and Majestic. Also, we have the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu anhu, sahih Muslim, that he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يُؤْتَى بِجَهَنَّمَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ لَهَا 70,000 زِمَامٍ That the hellfire will be brought forth on the Day of Judgment, being held down by 70,000 reins, like the reins of a horse. عَلَى كُلِّ زِمَامٍ 70,000 مَلَكٍ يَجُرُّونَهَا On every single one of these reins is 70,000 angels pulling it forward. So 70,000 times 70,000, you're talking about 4.9 billion angels just to contain the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and you from the horrors of that day. Allahumma ameen. Also, we're informed that the angels are magnificent in size. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith of Jabir, it was narrated by Ahmad and Abi Dawood, he says, أُذِنَ لِي أَنْ أَتَحَدَّثْ عَنْ مَلَكٍ مِنْ حَمَلَةِ الْعَرْشِ I was permitted to converse with one of the angels from those that carry the throne of Allah the Mighty and Majestic. He says, مَا بَيْنَ شَحْمَةِ أُذُنِهِ إِلَىٰ عَاتِقِهِ مَسِيرَةُ 700 عَامٍ The distance between the flesh of his ear till his shoulder is the distance of a 700 years travel. And considering we've mentioned this angel carries the throne, we also know that these angels do just that, carry out various tasks that Allah has ordained for them. So of the angels are those that carry the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of them, his name is Israfil, as we were informed in the authentic sunnah, that Israfil alayhi salam is the angel that will blow the trumpet for the day of judgment to commence. And Israfil is also one of those that carries the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, we have Mika'il, who is mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, who is the angel that Allah azza wa jal appointed to maintain and manage precipitation, rainfall, and agriculture, and the winds and the likes. Also, there is the angel Jibreel alayhi salam, the archangel, the greatest of them, who is the messenger of Allah to the messengers on earth. So he is the one trusted in the heavens to deliver the message to those trusted with Allah's message on earth. And also, for example, we have the angel of death that Allah Azza wa Jal speaks about in Surah Al-Sajda, wherein he says, قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي وُكِّلَ بِكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will be put to death by the angel of death that has been appointed over you, meaning for that task, they carry out various tasks. For that task, and then to your Lord, you will be returned. And since we agreed at the beginning of the episode that the matters of the unseen we are not allowed to speak about and make claims regarding without revelation, it's good to mention here as a practice of that, that some believe that the name of the angel of death is Azra'il. And this is not found in the book of Allah or in the sunnah of his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but rather it is found in the records of those that came before us. So we neither confirm it nor deny it, as we will discuss in our next episode, inshallah, azza wa jal, with regards to belief in the books and the scriptures. But there are other angels as well. We know that the angels that are with us record our deeds, as Allah the Most High says in Surah Al-Infitar, وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ And indeed appointed over you are recorders, كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ Noble angels that are scribes that they write, يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ They know that which you do. And also we believe in the guardian angels that Allah the Most High speaks about, wherein he says in Surah Al-Ra'd, لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ يَحْفَظُونَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ He has angels, successive angels, that take shifts upon the human being that protect him and safeguard him by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of them is appointed particularly at night. We know that from the hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, wherein the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appointed him, as Abu Hurairah says, as a security guard over the sadaqah, over the zakah. He says, so I was sitting there protecting what was given in zakah, the foodstuff. He says, and I caught a man creeping around stealing from it. So I grabbed him and said, I will refer you back to the Messenger of Allah. I'm going to bring you to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, please know my needs and my family and the likes. For the soft heart of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu is that he let him go. In the morning, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, what did your companion do, O Abu Hurairah? He said, O Messenger of Allah, he promised he wouldn't return. He said, O Abu Hurairah, he will return. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's words never missed the mark. The next night, Abu Hurairah standing guard and he finds the same man trying to steal from the zakah again. So he says, for sure, I'm going to take you to the Messenger of Allah. And the man begged and he pleaded until Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu took a promise from him that surely he will not. Surely he will not return. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the next morning told Abu Hurairah, he came again, didn't he? He will come again, meaning a third time. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, I will never let him go this third time. And in the third night when the man arrived, he grabbed him and said, nothing will stop me from bringing you to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, oh Abu Hurairah, if I teach you something from the book of Allah, were you to recite it, this is the point of reference here, you will continue to have a guardian from Allah protecting you until you awaken. If I teach it to you, will you let me go? So Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, with his love for knowledge and his love to come near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and know how to implement his book, he permitted. And the man told him, when you lay on your bed, recite, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. Ayatul Kursi, the 255th verse of Surah Al-Baqarah. He said, if you do so, you will continue to have a guardian standing on top of your head, protecting you until you awaken. So these are just some of the various tasks of the angels that we are informed about. Also, these angels, of their qualities that we're informed about, is that they are ever protective of the believers. Allah the Most High says, Surah Ghafir, الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. Those that bear the throne, that carry the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those around it, they celebrate the praises of their Lord, and they have iman in Him, and they believe in Him. But that's not all. وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And they seek forgiveness for those that have iman, for those that believe. And they say, رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا. O our Lord, your mercy and your knowledge have expanded wider than all things. فَغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا. So forgive those that repent. وَقِهِمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ. And shield them from the punishment of the blazing fire. O our Lord, and admit them among the people of paradise. وَأَدْخِلْهُمْ جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ. Admit them into the gardens of Eden. الَّذِي وَعَدْتَهُمْ وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَاتِهِمْ. Which you promised them along with their forefathers and their offspring and their wives. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Indeed, you are the most mighty, the most wise. وَقِهِمُ السَّيِّئَاتِ. O Allah, and protect them from the consequences of sin. And no one is protected from the consequences of sin on that day, except that you have delivered mercy to them. And that is the supreme success. This is a conversation, a plea made by the angels, and you can hear from their words how protective they are for the believers. For more about the angels, inshallah, we'll continue, but after a short break, stay with us.
A friendly message by Dr. Zakir. Old age home.
Al-Quran, Surah Al-Isra, chapter number 17, verses number 23 and 24 says, your Lord has decreed that you worship none but Him, and that you be kind to parents. Whether one or both of them attain old age in your life, say not a word of contempt. Do not say oof to them, nor repel them, but address them in terms of honor. And out of kindness, lower to them the wing of humility and say, my Lord, bestow on them your mercy, even as they cherished me in childhood. There is no place for old age home in Islam.
Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Dialogue. Discussion. Debate. Rebuttal. Conclusion.
Eliminate misconceptions about religion. Get enlightened.
Witness Dr. Zakir Naik in a battle of words in Crossfire every Saturday at 8:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 12:30 p.m. UK on Peace TV. Islam covers all aspects of this life and the hereafter.
We begin with the letter A. A is for what? A is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth.
The do's and don'ts, the freedom to choose, to decide our way of life.
My prayer, my fasting, my zakah, my hajj, my slaughter.
As per our wise creator's will or our uncertain human will.
Everything is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Bilal Ismail.
Purification, a super important matter in our sharia, as we will learn A to Z of purification.
Appreciate the holistic approach of Islam in dealing with various affairs of life in A to Z series. Tonight at 8 p.m. and repeat telecast at 8:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back. We concluded before the break discussing how protective the angels are for their brethren in faith, for the people of Iman. Because these angels have Iman, and they have a love for the people of Iman. And they seek forgiveness for the people of Iman. And this we learn from even for ourselves, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us to say, رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلَّ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. O our Lord, forgive us, and forgive our brethren that have preceded us in faith, and do not place in our hearts any rancor, any malice or ill feeling towards those that have Iman, towards those that believe. This is from the purity of the angels and how protective they are of the believers, as we should be as well. Also, of the qualities that we should know about the angels is that they are incapable of sinning. Some term this quality as them not having free will, but perhaps a more accurate description, or is intended by what they are saying, some of these scholars, is that they are incapable of committing a sin, where in reality, their will exists, but it is radically limited. So first of all, being incapable of sinning, this is established in Surah Al-Tahrim, wherein Allah Azza wa Jal, the Mighty and Majestic, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, O people of Iman, O believers, قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا, protect yourselves and your family from a fire, وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ, the fuel of this fire, its fuel is humans and stones. عَلَيْهَا مَلَائِكَةٌ غِلَاظٌ شِدَادٌ لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ. Upon this fire are angels that are strong and are fierce, that do not disobey Allah in the least with regards to what He commands them. وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ, and they are constantly doing that which they are instructed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us that they cannot commit a sin, they do exactly as they're instructed. As for them not having any free will at all, there are a few ahadith and even verses in the Qur'an that indicate that they are intelligent creatures, right? And they have a will, but it is radically limited. Some give the example of a horse that is tied to a chain. It can move, but it cannot move exactly everywhere that it wants to move. So for example, we have the ayat in Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed them that He is placing a khalifa on the earth, a human being, Adam alayhi salam, that will have successive generations and offspring on this planet. They said, O our Lord, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءِ, are you placing therein someone that will corrupt therein? So they said, you're going to put a creation on the earth, O Allah, that will corrupt in it and spill the blood of one another therein. Allah told them, I know that which you don't. So you have knowledge, but my knowledge is superior to yours, and there are things that are hidden from you. Also, of the qualities of the angels is that they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restlessly. In Surah Al-Anbiya, Allah the Most High, He says about them, يُسَبِّحُونَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ لَا يَفْتُرُونَ. They glorify Allah by night and by day, never slackening, meaning never slackening in that. They don't sleep, they don't eat. This is their task 24/7. So this was but a glimpse of the magnificent creation of the angels. So how do we benefit from it? What do we reap of fruits and harvest of lessons for our lives from our belief in the angels? The first of them is that this is a manifestation of Allah's power, the Almighty. Because Allah, the Most High, cannot be seen in this world. Also, the creation of the angels is an honoring for the believers. How? Because these pure, beautiful creatures who are incapable of sinning, we find out from the Quran that the human being and the jinn, the believing slaves that have free will, can surpass the angels in rank. The proof, the ayah in Surah Al-Bayyinah, Allah the Most High says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ. Indeed, those that have iman and work righteous acts, they are the best of creation. Ibn Kathir mentions, rahimahullah, Abu Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala an himself, he said, these are the words of Abu Hurairah, about this verse, they are even better than the angels. And the reason for that is obvious, in that a person that has the ability to sin and chooses to put his trust in Allah and give it his all and is determined not to sin is more praiseworthy than someone that could not sin to begin with and thus he didn't sin. For example, if we say this person has not drank wine for 20 years, though he had the ability to do so and he lived in a society that this was prevalent in, say, Allahu Akbar, this is quite impressive. As opposed to someone we say, he didn't murder for 20 years because he'd already murdered 20 years before that and he was in prison for 20 years and there was no one to murder, right? To resist the temptation is what raises the believers in their rank. And this is what is intended by Allah's statement, وَأَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. When they asked him, you're placing in this earth those that will wreak havoc in it, he said, I know what you don't. I know that among these human beings will be amazing creatures. Those that defy the odds by putting their reliance upon their creator and their maker, and they will be honored above the honoring of the angels. Also, another benefit from the world of the angels that we take, it is that it's a humbling reality. We see these angels that are greater than us in number and greater than us in size. And they worship Allah by night and by day still without feeling or slackening for a bit in that. This should have a person reflect and say, how can I possibly think that I have the right to worship Allah if I wish, however I wish? How can that be? The last verse in Surah Al-A'raf, Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي. Indeed, those that are with your Lord, meaning the angels, they are not too proud to worship Him, not too proud to lower their heads in humility, and their hearts before that, surrendering to His might and His power and His glory, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, there's the hadith, Salman al-Farisi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that these angels, on the day of judgment, once the hour begins, they will say, Subhana ma abadnaka haqqa ibadati. Glorified you are, O Allah, we have not worshipped you in the manner that you deserve to be worshipped. After all this. So the human being thinks, what have I done? Right? The little bit that I can do, I should do. And then that little bit, because Allah is a shakur, the most appreciating, He will accept of me and raise my rank. So it's a humbling reality. And it grants you a bit of gratitude for Allah, rather a great bit of gratitude for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what He accepts of us, despite our limited abilities and despite our very tight capacity. Also of the benefits of believing in the angels is that it's a manifestation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy and His grace, and that He is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, and He is the most gentle, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you think of all the ways that Allah commissioned the angels to care for you, O son of Adam, you realize who this beautiful, loving God is. And Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he mentioned it in a beautiful list where he weaved together the tasks of the angels and their relationship with the human being from the moment he's created till the moment is served his delights in paradise in Ghathul Lahfan. And I believe personally that it would be a disservice to the viewer for me to not bring you the words of Ibn al-Qayyim himself. So bear with me, inshallah. I have adapted it for length, but listen to these words. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he says, know that Allah created you and the angels, and He fused between your lives that is indicative. It proves His wonderful mercy and benevolence, if you but knew. He says, and the angels are appointed over the human being from the time he's a drop of sperm until the end of his affair, the very end of his existence, which will not end in reality. He says they are responsible for forming and molding him, and then carrying him from stage to stage, meaning in the womb of his mother, protecting him throughout within these three layers of darkness, writing his provisions, his actions, his lifespan, and prosperity or wretchedness, whether he will be prosperous or whether he'll be doomed, accompanying him in all of his conditions, recording his words and his actions, safeguarding him during his life, grabbing his soul at death, displaying it before his creator and originator. He says they're also appointed over the instruments of bliss and punishment. They are the fortifiers of the believing slave by Allah's consent, those that teach him the beneficial, those that fight in his defense. They are his guardians in this world and the next, those that encourage him with good and invite to it, discouraging him from evil and warning from it. Therefore, they are his allies and supporters. These are all ayat and ahadith, but he weaved them together to give you that warm, beautiful picture. He says, therefore, they are his allies and supporters, his guardians and teachers, his advisors, his supplicators, those that pray for him, those who seek forgiveness for him and pray for him to be blessed so long as he teaches people good. They bring him glad tidings of Allah's reward in his dreams, and then at his death, and upon resurrection. They are the ones that disinterest him in this world, and arouse his interest in the hereafter, and keep him firm when he is frightened. And this is also another benefit of the angels, is that our belief in the angels fills us with confidence, that this is of the soldiers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he sends for those that he loves, whenever he wishes, in an instant. As Allah the Most High says in Surah Al-Muddathir, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. No one knows the soldiers of Allah but him, the troop of Allah but him. He sends them as reinforcement to keep the believer firm at heart and to reassure him. As Allah mentioned, sending them at the Battle of Badr and elsewhere, he says, وَمَا جَعَلَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بُشْرًا. And he only sent it as a glad tidings for you. And finally, the last of the lessons that we'll mention, inshallah, Azza wa Jal, with regards to belief in the angels, is that it protects the heart of the believer from many of the confusions and misconceptions that those that don't know about the angels from Quran and Sunnah are subjected to. For example, the people of Christianity have confused the Prophet from the angel, from the Lord, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. That is because they worshipped the angel at one point, not knowing that it was a servant of Allah. And at times they thought that the angel himself was Allah. And at times they thought that Allah was the Prophet. Why? That knowledge of the Quran and Sunnah helps us discern the reality and not be confused. And this is from Allah's bounty for revealing His book and sending His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until next time, sallallahu ma'a nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Pray, bow down, prostrate. You are the only one worthy of praise. I stand before you with an attentive heart. Erase my sins from the present and past. To you I pray, bow down, prostrate. You are the only one worthy of praise. I stand before you with an attentive heart. Erase my sins from the present and past.
The value of money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqu mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatu wa la shafa'a.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK. B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3. 1-800-8301-1323-01, sort code 300083, SWIFT BIC code ARAYGB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace Team, the solution for humanity.